Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
Yes, you can negotiate that residual, and sometimes it's definitely to your advantage. The residual is, of course, the guaranteed price that you can buy your lease car for at the end of your lease, or even sooner. And the residual is a guess of what that value is going to be. If you have a 2-year, 3-year, even a 5-year lease, the manufacturer is going to have to get his crystal ball out and say, I think this is what this Lexus LS460 is going to be worth in 36 months. Now, it's almost impossible to hit that on the head. So usually the guess, the residual, therefore, is too high or too low. Now, if the residual is too low, that's when you jump all over it, because now you have a legal right to buy that car at a below market price, and the manufacturer is locked in to honor that contractual obligation. So you should always check. Now, let's say the residual is too high. Well, obviously, you don't want to be obligated to buy it at too high a price, but supposing you really like the car. And here's where the negotiation comes in. You say to the dealer, I'd like to buy that car, but I think the price is way off. Now, usually it's the dealer that would have to contact the leasing company. And the leasing company oftentimes, most often, is the manufacturer. But it could be a bank. Either way, the bank or the leasing company would know that we guessed wrong 3 years ago. We guessed high. The car is $1,000 over the market, which means I'm just going to have to take it to the auction and sell it. And if I take it to the auction and sell it, I'm going to lose $1,000. Maybe we'll split the difference and we'll sell it for $500 off. That'll save us $500. But it's negotiable, and they can be thousands of dollars off. There have been some times when we've had extreme changes in the used car market. Recently, we had an extreme change. Used car prices have gone way up because during this recession, people kept their new cars. They didn't trade them in, so there's a shortage of used cars. And many residuals out there were guessed at before the recession came upon us, and therefore the prices of the residual could be too high. So work with your dealer. Never just pay the price on the contract. Always get the actual market value. You do that as you get toward the end of your lease by taking that car. Let's say you're driving a Honda. You go to 3 different Honda dealers and you say, I want to sell this car. You obviously can't sell the car because it's not your car, it's a lease car, but you don't have to tell them that. Just say, I'm thinking about selling the car. Give me your best price. I'm going to 2 other Honda dealers. That'll establish the market value far better than trying to look it up in a book or going on the computer. You get the real local actual market value. Then you compare that to the residual. If the residual on your vehicle is lower than the market price, then jump on that residual, exercise your right to buy the car.